Let's quickly understand, what is HETP and why is it so important in mass transfer operations? So HETP stands for height equivalent to a theoretical plate. Then it plays a key role in describing how efficient a separation equipment is, like distillation, absorption, or extraction columns. Now, here's the definition. So, HETP is simply the height of packing or column section that gives the same separation as one theoretical plate in a plate column. To understand this, let's imagine a distillation column, which is made of trays, where each tray acts like one theoretical plate, and on each tray vapor and liquid reach equilibrium. But in a packed column, there are no trays. Hence for packed column, we use HETP to tell how much height of packing is equal to one theoretical plate. Then mathematically HETP can be calculated as HETP equal to the height of the packed section divided by the number of theoretical plates. Now let's talk about the role or importance of HETP. So first point is, HETP helps to measure column efficiency. So if the HETP value is small, that means the column is very efficient, because each small section of packing gives one equilibrium stage. And if the HETP is large, the efficiency is lower. Then next point is, it's used to compare different packings. For example, materials like Rishik rings, ball rings, or structured packings all have different HETP values. A good packing has a low HETP, it means columns performs better with less height. Then HETP helps in column design. So for a given separation, we can find how many theoretical plates are required from the equilibrium data, and once we know that number, we multiply it by HETP to get the actual height of the column. Hence we can write, column height is equal to number of plates into HETP. And finally, it helps to connect plate columns and packed columns. Because with the help of HETP, we can express the performance of a packed column in terms of theoretical plates, which were originally defined for tray columns. Then typical values of HETP are, for random packing, 0.3 to 1.0 meters, and for structured packing, 0.1 to 0.5 meters.